The COVID vaccine is the world's great hope in helping end the pandemic, each milestone heralded with great fanfare. The federal government set itself the ambitious goal of having almost every Australian adult vaccinated by October.
Our goal is always under-promise, over-deliver, and we expect that Australians will be fully vaccinated by the end of October.
Back in January, the Prime Minister was raising expectations with this big aspiration.
We hoped by the end of March, I should say, to have reached some 4 million population. That is a target. That is what we are working to.
It's now mid-March and the vaccination rollout is in its third week. But so far, just 125,000 people have been vaccinated, well below the 4 million initially projected. And now that the target has fallen behind, there seems to be a new message from the government.
It's not a race.
This is not a race.
It's not a race. It's not a competition.
He set up an expectation in the community that it's going to be available now. He said, starting in February, starting in March, 4 million at the end of March, and we're now saying, well, hang on, you told us we were going to have that. You said this was what the date was going to be, and it hasn't been.
So far, Australia has been relying on vaccine shipped from overseas, but Italy has blocked supplies of AstraZeneca. Today, the government's top health bureaucrat revealed lack of supply was part of the problem, while local stock was yet to kick in.
We haven't had access to the international doses that we thought we'd get because of we thought we would get 3.8 million AstraZeneca doses, and for issues that I think the committee is well aware of with sovereign vaccine issues in Europe, we've only had 700-odd thousand AstraZeneca vaccines.
We haven't ramped up the CSL production yet. I think they're going to start producing a million a week from later on this month. So there's been no serious local production.
Giving evidence in a Senate committee today, the Secretary of the Health Department, Brendan Murphy, faced a torrent of questions about the delays, revealing that not all Australians would receive the second shot of vaccine by the October deadline.
I suspect it's unlikely we will have completed the second doses of AstraZeneca vaccines by then.
But that's because the recommended period between the first and second dose has now changed from 4 weeks to 12.
Our message from government is to offer everyone a vaccine by the end of October, and that's the main overarching plan.
But that's one vaccine now.
Well, it could be two vaccines. Most people with AstraZeneca will have had two by then, but there may be some at the end of October that might have only had one. But the great majority of people will have had two vaccines by then, and everyone will have had one. And it's a semantic difference whether a small proportion have to come back a little bit later for their second dose. They will have been protected by the first dose.
Well, semantic. I think I've heard the Health Minister, the Prime Minister, the Treasurer all say people will be fully, you know, offered their vaccination by October.
There will be. They will be.
Implying two shots. Your evidence today, Dr. Murphy, is not that.
No, I'm not saying differently one way or the other.
The government's hoping the introduction of the AstraZeneca vaccine later this month will help speed up the rollout, with more than 4,500 GPs boosting the workforce. That's when people over 70, Indigenous people over 55, and young people with underlying conditions will receive the vaccine.
I think political deadlines needn't be our deadlines. We've been working in our clinic since the beginning of the year, plotting how we would deliver vaccines to our population.
Dr. Mukesh Haikerwal, a former AMA president, is gearing up at his clinic in Melbourne's West.
The main issue is getting vaccine in store in our fridges so that we can call people and know we've got something to give them. We can start the next phase, which is making sure we've got enough staff on board, getting them up to speed, making sure we've got the vaccinators here. General practice has been part of vaccinations for generations, from birth into retirement age. We are here to do vaccinations and we'll make this happen.
The vaccination program is set to pick up the pace on the 22nd of March, when locally produced doses of AstraZeneca begin to roll out and give the government a clearer idea of timeframes.
it can actually be really clear by saying we'll have so many doses produced every week and this is who's going to get it, and so they should absolutely come clean about who's going to get it, what the priority is, what the expectation is, and how many are going to be vaccinated every week from the 22nd of March onwards.
Hi, I'm Lee Sales. Thanks for watching this story. If you'd like to watch more of 7:30's stories, they are on the left of your screen. And tap on the button below to subscribe and get the latest from ABC News.